Hey everyone, this is Scott from certmedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to set up a Cloudflare for your WordPress website. If you've never used Cloudflare, I'm going to give you a brief overview of what it is. It's a DNS service, which means it hosts your domain's name servers, which allows it to route your domain name to the server's IP address at your web host. Cloudflare is not a web host. It is a CDN and a DNS provider. It is also a firewall provider to help prevent your website from getting DDoSed and to prevent spam. It is a free service, but there are paid tiers. In this plan, I'm going to be showing you how to set up the free tier. So what you're going to need is you're going to need a couple things. You're going to need access to your domain registrar. This is where you purchased your domain. In my case, I purchased all my domains through Google Domains. And then you're going to need access to your own Cloudflare.com account. Once you do, you're probably going to get a menu similar to this, or you may be prompted to add a site right away. In which case, no matter what, you're going to click add a site. You're going to get your domain name and you're just going to copy it in. You do not need to include any protocols or the subdomain. So the website Nashville Unbound is the URL that I'm going to be adding. I'm going to click add site. You're going to click the tier that you want. If you're just starting out with the service, I recommend that you start with a free tier to get a feel for it. And if your website is making a decent amount of money, then I do recommend slowly upgrading as your needs evolve. If it's a news type website and you're gaining a good chunk of traffic or a very popular blog, the pro version has a lot of awesome tools in it to help optimize your images, among other resources. But if you're just starting out, the free version is totally acceptable. You're going to click confirm plan. Now what it's doing is it's scanning your existing DNS records. So what that means, it's going to find your existing DNS records and try to import them so that way your website doesn't go down during the name transfer process. So as you can see, it's found my A record and my C name, and then it found the C name for Google domains and a wildcard that I set up. What you typically want to do is make sure that you're only proxying what you have to avoid issues. For instance, if you proxy on some host, the web disk or the cPanel, you may be unable to access those services after doing so. So make sure that you're really only processing the www and your A record for your root domain name, which in this case is Nashville Unbound, and the rest we're going to unproxy. That way we avoid any intermittent issues that may occur from accessing mail to accessing your cPanel, and this all varies host to host. My existing host is Cloudways. So we're going to click continue, and now it says that we need to replace our existing records with the name servers that it provides. All that you need to do is go to your domain registrar and update the name servers that it provides. You are not able to do this from your host unless that host is where you purchased your domain. You cannot update this in cPanel. You need to update what's known as the authoritative name servers, which can only be done at your domain registrar. So with Google domains, they make it really simple. You just click on use custom name servers and you paste the two name servers that are provided. Now keep in mind, so long as you've validated that all the records that were imported are indeed there. So as I can see, my four records down here, plus the one that Google domains adds for its connect feature are all imported. So I can go ahead and hit the save button to add these name servers. Now it'll take anywhere from 24 to 48 hours for Cloudflare to show as active. In that time, your website will not go down. And if you're in some countries like the US and the UK, you may notice the time between upgrading to Cloudflare's DNS service to be shorter instead of the normal 24 to 48 hour periods. It really depends on a combination of your internet service provider and how often your computer caches the resource. Once you're done, all you need to do is click check name servers and then just skip the setup process for later. We will go through that in another video to show you the optimal settings for your Cloudflare account. If you have any questions about the setup process, or if you're unsure what you need to do, or if you're having issues with it, please feel free to ask in the comments below and I will try to help you out. Thank you so much for watching and goodbye.